We are here with Dr. Nitesh Jain, who is a urologist consultant in Apollo Chennai. We are going to be talking about him, about myths of kidney stones. Number 1. Hydrotherapy can flush out urinary calculi.
Well, hydrotherapy or the flush therapy, which is very commonly used by many physicians, is not the ideal treatment for kidney stone because it increases the intrarenal pressure and it can lead to rupture of fornices. So it should not be used and its use should be condemned. The best thing is you can drink enough water, which will help in flushing out of the stone. So hydrotherapy is not the treatment of care for kidney stone patient.
Barley water is good for preventing and dissolving urinary stones.
Well, barley water is just like any other water. It have got mild diuretic properties, so it will again form more stone and it may help in flushing out of the stone. Its value is as good as water.
Everyone must drink 3 to 4 liters of water a day.
Well, it all depends on the climate you live in, the work you do. Because if you stay in a very comfortable climate, in an air-conditioned room, then you probably may not need that much of water. But if you work in a very hot and humid climate, or you are doing a very heavy work, then probably you will need more water. The best guide is your thirst. If you are thirsty, drink water, don't avoid it. And the second best guide is the color of urine. It should not be too dark, it should be pale yellow or clear in color.
Beer helps in reducing kidney stones.
This again is a very common myth. What happens, beer actually have got some diuretic properties, so it will form more urine and may help in flushing out of the stone because of its diuretic property. But beer have got oxalates and some phosphoric acid. It can increase the formation of stone. It can also lead to dehydration because of increased urine output. And beer have got added calories in it, which can increase the weight, which again is a risk factor for kidney stone patients.
Restriction of calcium in the diet helps to reduce urinary stone reoccurrence.
Any patient with kidney stone should not restrict their calcium intake. In fact, all the kidney stone have calcium in it. Still, body needs calcium. What happens once you take some calcium in your diet? The oxalate in our diet get excreted. It combines with the calcium and it gets excreted in stool rather than in urine. One of the common form of kidney stone is a calcium oxalate stone. So, if the dietary calcium level is less, the amount of oxalate which is excreted in the urine is more and you may form more and more stone. So you should have adequate amount of calcium in your diet, and you should have at least 1 glass of milk or curd in your diet daily.
There are medications to dissolve urinary stones.
80% of the kidney stones are calcium oxalate or phosphate, and medication does not affect their dissolving. Some stone like uric acid stone or cystine stone can be dissolved with medicine. So it all depends on the chemical composition of the stone, type of stone, which can be treated with medicines.
Shock wave lithotripsy can be used to treat renal calculi of any size and form.
Shockwave lithotripsy is a form of therapy in which we give ultrasonic wave from externally and we blast the stone into small fragments. It all depends on type of stone, where the stone is located, how big is the stone, and whether it is causing what degree of obstruction. Not all stone can be treated with shockwave lithotripsy. Small stone or which are just causing mild obstruction, there is no infection, can be treated with shockwave lithotripsy. So you need to consult to your urologist whether that particular stone can be treated or cannot be treated with shockwave lithotripsy.
Staghorn or large renal calculi cannot be treated by endoscopic surgery, i.e. PCNS.
Well, most of the kidney stone can be treated with endoscopic surgery, whatever the size it may be. Even large Stagon calculus, which are present in the kidney, can be easily dealt with endoscopic surgery. Here, PCNL is the standard form of treatment for large stone, where we make a small puncture behind the back. The puncture may be a single or two or three, depending on the size of the stone, and we remove the stone with the help of laser or lithotripter. So, majority of the stone can be treated with endoscopic surgery. Hardly need any open surgery for stone.
Once a stone is formed, it will not form again.
That's not true. Once you are a stone former, there is a lifelong risk of forming stone again. So you need to follow proper dietary advice, and in case if you are having recurrent stone, then you need metabolic evaluation. So you need to consult your urologist, who will guide you what treatment is needed, what medication is needed, and will help you in prevention of the stone.
Stones without symptoms can be kept untreated.
That again is not true. Majority of the stone, if symptomatic, may need some treatment, but it all depends on the size of the stone and location of the stone. Very small stone, majority of the time, can be treated with conservative measures or with some medicines. Larger stone, if they are blocking the kidney, needs some treatment. And many large stones sometimes may be symptomatic, but over a period of time, they can affect the kidney. So they again need treatment. So even if the patient is not having any symptoms, you need to consult your urologist, who can assess your kidney function, the location and size of the stone, and can decide what is the best form of treatment for you.
Thank you, Dr. Nitesh Jain, for clearing out all these myths about kidney stones.
Thank you.